Good morning, my dear students. Today we all are going to start our activity work. So as you all know that nowadays we are learning the chapter decimals. So here we are doing the activity related to the same topic, that is multiplication of decimals. And I know that everyone likes to do activities. So now it's time to do this, okay? So, but before this, children, I want to share some instructions with you. So all need to be focused on that. You all have to do this activity in practical file. You all know which type of practical file we have to make. It will be bigger in size rather than a notebook. Okay, here one side blank page and one side lining page, you know about that, the practical file. And at the back side of it, there are the graph papers also. So you have to do this activity in practical file. This is the activity number one. Now, after doing the activity in practical file, how you have to do this activity in practical file? That is, do the writing work on lining page. One side, as I said, is lining page. So all the written work you have to do on lining page, and the pasting work on plain page. Whatever cutting and pasting we will do, that will be on plain page you have to do. Now the third, that is very important, upload your activity after completing it by Thursday. It means 13th of August. Now I hope the instructions are clear to everyone. Now let's start our activity. Children, as you all are not about that this is the activity based on the topic multiplication of decimal. So here we will do multiplication of decimals. So what is the aim? Actually, we are doing the multiplication on graph paper, and for this I have taken one example, 0.3 multiplied by 0.7. so we have to show this multiplication, this product, on a graph paper. Now when we will take the graph paper, so which type of graph paper we need, what materials we require. So I am telling you what material we require. We need a graph paper for this. As I told, whatever practical file you are using, at the back of it there are graph paper. Otherwise you can take any graph paper. Sketch pens, different colors, a pair of scissors and Fevicol. So these are the material which is required. And there is prerequisite knowledge. It means before doing this activity, what knowledge we need. We should know the concept of multiplication of decimal. And nowadays we are learning the multiplication of decimal. So everyone knows how to solve that. Okay, let's move further what we have to do. So children, here you can see I have taken one graph paper, as you all can see on the screen. Yes, this is a graph paper. Now, what is the speciality of this graph paper? It is a 10 cross 10 grid. 10 cross 10 means there are 10 vertical lines and 10 horizontal lines. So, 10 10 ja 100. It is a graph paper where 100 big boxes are there. Big box, I mean to say this one. Okay, one big box. सो 10 क्रॉस 10 100, 10 क्रॉस 10 का आपको एक ग्राफ पेपर लेना है. नाउ व्हाट वी हैव टू डू विद दिस ग्राफ पेपर, ओके लेट्स बी फोकस ऑन प्रोसीजर. सो टेक अ ग्राफ पेपर एंड कट 10 क्रॉस 10 ग्रिड्स फ्रॉम इट. 10 वर्टिकल एंड 10 हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइन का आपको एक ग्राफ पेपर लेना है. नाउ आफ्टर दिस, ऑन दिस ग्रिड शेड 3 कॉलम यूजिंग पिंक स्केच पेन. Actually, our question was 0.3 into 0.7. So here, first I am taking this first number 0.3. Now 0.3, we know it is 3 by 10. Am I clear? 3 by 10. So children, here 10 vertical and 10 horizontal line. So I have to use two different color. So here I am taking pink sketch pen first. So I have to shade three column. I can shade rows is my choice, but one time rows, one time column. So first I am shading three column with pink sketch pen. The shaded area will represent as the decimal number 0.3. Then with another sketch pen I use for that purple 0.7. It means I have to shade 7 rows using purple sketch pen. So the shaded area shows the 0.7. So what happened, children? Whatever double shaded region you will get, that will represent 0.21. And if you will see the multiplication of 0.3 and 0.7, it is only 0.21. So let's do with me. With the shading, how can we get the 0.21 shaded region? Okay, so we conclude that 0.3 into 0.7 equals to 0.21. Let's learn on graph paper. So here, as I told, this is our graph, and first I have to take pink color for shading the what? Shading the three columns. Am I clear? Okay, so I am shading three column, three vertical line with pink color. Carefully, neat and clean. Everyone has to do that. You can shade full or you can shade like I am doing with lining. It's your choice. So I have shaded three columns. How many columns are left here? 7. If you will count, I shade only three vertical lines. So it shows me 0.3. Okay. It shows me the 0.3 or not? Yes. Okay. Now I have the another digit was 0.7. So I have to shade now 7 horizontal line with another color. So for that I am using the purple color. 7 horizontal. Okay. So let me shade 7. I have to shade. So till here it will be 7. So children, when I am shading the 7 horizontal, please don't shade only that part which is not shaded. It will be overlap this also. It means full horizontal line we have to shade. Okay. In this manner, I have shaded 7 horizontal line. Fine. Okay. So what you have observed? That we get some of the portion that is double shaded. Can you see? Some columns are double shaded. Yes? Okay. So if we start counting these double shaded portion. Look, I am encircle that double shaded portion so that it's clear to you. And this one is 0.7 part. Because total 10 horizontal line was there, and out of 10 I have shaded 7 horizontal lines. So 7 by 10 it shows. And how many vertical line I was having? 10. 10 vertical only, so 3 vertical. So 3 out of 10. So it 3 by 10 shows 0.3. I hope the decimal is clear. Now their multiplication, it means their double shaded portion that I am encircling. So you can observe, children, this portion is double shaded. Yes. So when you count the boxes, number of boxes, it will 21. And 21 boxes out of how many? 100. Because total 100 boxes are there, and out of 100 boxes, 21 were double shaded. And double shaded portion will show us what? The product of these two. So 21 upon 100 will show us 0.21 when we write in decimal. So that's why the double shaded portion will show us the product. So I hope the activity is clear to everyone. So what is our observation with this activity? That 0.3 into 0.7 equals to 0.21. This is the way by which we have to do this activity. Now, everyone has to complete this activity. Use attractive colors, make your work creative and upload it by the given time. Thank you and have a nice day.